Buenas tardes a todos. Agradezco la presencia de cada una de las personalidades que nos acompañan en este evento tan especial, sobre todo a los que han llegado desde lejos, viajando muchas horas para estar con nosotros en este lugar tan importante. Quiero resaltar el trabajo minucioso e intenso de nuestra coordinadora en Alaska, Claudia Jones, y de todos los hombres y mujeres, las embajadoras, que han colaborado con ella para hacer de la cumbre de diplomacia y liderazgo todo un éxito. Muchas gracias a todos por participar. La medalla iberoamericana, con la medalla iberoamericana honramos a hombres y mujeres que son agentes de cambio sobresalientes en el ámbito donde se desarrollan, con historias de vida convertidas en éxito. Esta medalla ha sido entregada a personalidades de muy alto nivel en diferentes partes del mundo. Quiero comentarles que esta medalla la ha recibido, por ejemplo, Rigoberta Menchú, que ha sido Premio Nobel de la Paz, el futbolista astro del fútbol Ronaldinho, y también el escritor Robert Kiyosaki, autor del bestseller Padre Rico, Padre Pobre, entre muchos otros que han tenido exitosas historias de vida y que para nosotros son muy merecedores de reconocimiento con esta medalla iberoamericana. La Fundación Honoris Causa, en vinculación con el Consejo de Comunidades Hispanas, y la fundación que preside el doctor Marco Tardelli, que es un genio creativo, se ha preocupado porque cada una de las medallas que vamos a otorgar en este momento sean personalidades distinguidas y en una mesa directiva, junto con nuestra coordinadora de Alaska, Claudia Jones, se decidió a las siguientes 6 personalidades que a continuación van a recibir la medalla. Le pido por favor a Claudia Jones que nos dirija unas palabras. Muchas gracias.
Dear guests, distinguished honorees, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Claudia Jones, and it is a profound honor for me in my role as the president of the Honoris Causa Foundation in Alaska to present the Ibero-American Medal to such illustrious individuals. This recognition not only celebrates your outstanding achievements, but also the positive impact you have made on your communities and the global stage. The Ibero-American Medal symbolizes not just excellence and dedication, but also a commitment to the values and principles that unite our international community. By bestowing this honor, we celebrate the collaboration and tireless effort that have contributed to advancement and development across various fields. Through your hard work and unwavering dedication, you have inspired and motivated many. Today, we have the privilege of acknowledging your exceptional contributions. This moment is one of joy and gratitude as we highlight not only your individual accomplishments, but also the lasting impact you have had in your respective fields. Congratulations to all the awardees. May this medal serve as a constant reminder of the excellence you have achieved and as an encouragement to continue your commendable paths.
Okay, our first medal recipient is Andrew Kurka. He is Team USA Para-Alpine skier, and he will be receiving the Ibero-American Sports Medal, given by Gloria Arredondo. Andrew is a Paralympic gold and silver medalist born in Palmer, Alaska. He started skiing shortly after injuring his spine at age 13. Andrew has had to overcome adversity to become a dominant force in adaptive skiing, while at the same time inspiring others because their determination and achievements. Let's give it up again once more for Andrew Kurtzman.
Thank you. If you're wondering why this gringo is on stage and how I'm Latin community, you can take a look back there at my wife, Veronica. Okay, Sara, stand up. Stand up, babe. Yeah, stand up. Now, the one thing that I've found through all of my travels and through being married to a Latin lady is that family is above all else. And when I married her, I was very warmly welcomed in the local Latin community. And that means the world to me, why I'm up here on stage and why her family is there in a row and why all of you are all here is because of family. And that's something that's huge. You know, we're up here, we're in Alaska, you're in the great white north, and somehow we're still able to all come together as one large family to be proud of who we are and to be proud of one another and to be proud of the futures that we all have together. And so thank you for this award. I really greatly appreciate it from the depths of my heart. I'm very proud to be part of this family. I'm very proud to be up here.
Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. Our next recipient is Mr. Charles R. Parker, is President and CEO of Alaska Village Initiative. Presenting the Medal on Activism is Brandy Farmer. Charles' family originally comes from Coimbo and Cosutebu. I hope I said that correct. I'm sorry, I apologize. And he is a Siknasuak and Bering Strait shareholder from Nome, who was enrolled with the Nome Eskimo community. Charles attended Dartmouth College in Hanover, New Hampshire, where he graduated with a bachelor's degree in sociology. Since returning to Alaska, Charles has assisted tribes, nonprofits, and Alaska Native corporations by providing training and facilitating projects in rural Alaska. Let's give him a nice hand. Thank you, Mr. Parker.
Okay, there we go. Sorry, I had to make sure I didn't yell into the mic. But thank you folks very much for having me here today. I'd like to thank my wife from Mexico and my Mexico boys. Who are also here today. This celebration is very close to my heart. I want to thank you guys because it was my mother that set me on this mountain. And she did so because she trained me to be a leader of my family. But she wanted to give me the education so I could be a leader of my people. Because without that education, you are dependent upon others. To have an equal seat at the table, you have to have the knowledge, the language, and the understanding of what's going on. So that is what I do for a living, and I appreciate every single one of you. Our honorees, our doctorates, fantastic work, and I appreciate you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Parker. Oh, wait, hold on. Little birdie just came over me and told me that it's your birthday. Woo! Oh, come on. Mañanitas or happy birthday?
Happy birthday.
Mr. Parker.
Happy birthday.
There'll be some cake in the front later on. Thank you. All right, our next recipient is Adelina Rodriguez. She's a scholarship program officer from Matsu Health Foundation. And presenting the Medal on Diversity and Inclusion is Genoveva Diaz. Adelina Rodriguez is dedicated to advancing diversity, equity, and inclusion. Her work focuses on fostering understanding and equality across communities. With a commitment to advocacy and education, she promotes inclusive environments where every voice matters. Adelina's efforts contribute to creating positive social change and cultivating a culture of respect and acceptance.
Disculpa, no me gusta estar enfrente, me decidí estar acá atrás.
Pero para empezar, to start, thank you for the introduction. I would like to first start with a land acknowledgement. So Matsu is situated on the ancestral homelands of the Atna and the Dena'ina peoples. I respectfully acknowledge the Atna and Dena'ina people, past, present, future, for their stewardship of this land where my family lives, learns, and plays in. I'm honored and humbled to be with you today. I want to thank Dr. Claudia Jones for recognizing my work in diversity, inclusion, and equity. As a Latina, I've often seen the social injustices that come with speaking a different language, having different race, ethnicity, gender, socioeconomic status, disability, perceived health, to name a few. As a graduate student enrolled in a program with a focus on social justice is how I learned how to recognize and understand the impact that social structures make in impeding progress for all, in all aspects of life, including where we live, where we go to school, and how we receive medical care, and more, much more. Unfortunately, social injustices happen every day, as it is a learned behavior and systematically influences our daily interactions. It is our responsibility to be part of the change. Our differences should be viewed as strengths. For example, being bilingual or multilingual is advantageous, as you can communicate with another person in a different language, which is an inclusive practice. This is there's a great body of research that supports the idea that knowing another language enhances the understanding and appreciation of the culture, leading to changing attitudes and beliefs of people and expanding worldly views. So in conclusion, respect is the key, and embracing the uniqueness that brings everyone to the table as an asset. So thank you, y gracias por este honor.
Thank you, Alina, for your great words. And Mr. Jesse is concerned over there. He thought we forgot about him. I apologize. There's got to be some glitches, right? You're fine, right? Your medal is on the mail. It's coming in. No, I'm kidding. We have it right here, sir. We have it right here. So the next recipient is Mr. Jesse Lopez. He's a program coordinator of PEP, and he will be receiving the Ibero-American Medal on Philanthropy. And presenting his medal will be Marco Polo Valladolid. There it is. Jesse Lopez was born in the Mexican state of Sinaloa. Anybody from Sinaloa? Mi esposa de Sinaloa? He is married and has three children. Mr. Lopez worked with the PEP, which is the Portable Practical Educational Preparation Youth Build Programs, for 2 decades, training farm worker, youth, and housing construction skills, GED preparation, and college certifications. He was named Man of the Year in Arizona, not just once, but twice. His work with youth has been recognized nationally, with hundreds of young people being trained to acquire various skills. Let's give him a hand, please.
Thank you for such a wonderful welcome. And I really believe that the dream come true only if you work on it. So, and we are in the space, we are in Alaska, Hispanic people are hard working. So thank you for the foundation. Thank you for everybody to do this possible. And, César Chávez said, and si se puede, si se pudo, y si se podrá. Thank you. Claro que se puede.
The next recipient is Mr. Agustin Sanchez, an activist. He will be receiving the Ibero-American Humanitarian Medal. And this medal will be presented by Raquel Besudo. Mr. Sanchez has a significant history of community involvement in Alaska. After moving here in 1976 and becoming a member of Laborers Local 341 until his retirement in 1995, he dedicated himself to various volunteer activities. Since 1990, his contributions have included work with Our Lady of Guadalupe Church, OLA, which is the Hispanic Organization of Latin Americans, CLASE, which is the Coalition of Latino Organizations in Support of Education, and their local radio station, La KSK 91.1, IME, which is the Institute for Mexicans Abroad, La Federación de Michoacanos de Alaska. A notable achievement includes advocating for the establishment of a Mexican consulate office in Alaska. He presented the needs of the community to the Mexican Congress, resulting in the opening of a consulate in 2008.
Gracias. Ya lo dijo todo él. Nada más quiero agradecer a todo el equipo que hizo posible este evento, agradecer a mi esposo, a mis hijos y a toda la comunidad que me ha conocido por lo que he hecho. He puesto mi granito de arena y seguiré poniéndolo mientras que pueda. Muchas gracias a todos y bienvenidos aquí a Alaska, a todos los que vienen de afuera.
Our next recipient will be Liliana Sanchez. She will be receiving the Ibero-American Medal Humanist. It will be presented by Dr. Navarro, none other than Dr. Navarro. She is the president of the Mexican Federation of Sports Yoga. As a speaker and president of the Mexican Federation of Sports Yoga, she spearheads an initiative advocating for a bill in the Mexican Congress to incorporate sports yoga into school curriculum. The aim is to combat bullying and childhood obesity. Como ponente y presidenta de la Federación Mexicana de Yoga Deportivo, lidera una iniciativa que aboga por un proyecto de ley en el Congreso Mexicano para incorporar el yoga deportivo en los programas escolares. El objetivo es combatir el acoso escolar y la obesidad infantil. Let's give her a hand, please. Liliana Sánchez.
Recibes esta medalla con un gran compromiso, porque esta medalla iberoamericana, así como todos los que los acaban de recibir, es una medalla que va más allá, iberoamericana, España, México hacia abajo, islas, países hispanos, países españoparlantes. Entonces, para nosotros es decirte que este compromiso que contraes y esta obligación que estás haciendo en México de llevar yoga deportivo como este deporte para quitar de malas ideas, quitar de estos sentimientos, de estos tremendos traumas que traen los jovencitos a través del yoga, a sus profesores, también ahora tienes que llevarlo hacia Iberoamérica, hacia los diferentes países, a través de su legislación, como está luchando en México, y sé que lo vas a lograr, porque te vamos a ayudar. Pero acuérdate, ya está aprobada la ley, era cierto. Acuérdate que es el logro que llevaste en México, aquí, también en Alaska, y en todo lo que es la parte de Estados Unidos, tenemos pueblo iberoamericano, tenemos este gran parte de apoyo hacia todos ustedes. Así que esta gran medalla iberoamericana está contigo, por tus logros, por tus hechos, por tu gran desarrollo. Y nuevamente este impulso llevado por mujeres hacia mujeres con todo el valor agregado. Así es que felicidades, y en este momento pongo tu gran medalla para que sigas desarrollando tu gran valor. Thank Aquí está tu reconocimiento. Ibero-American Medal, Fundación Mariscal 2024. In recognition of this distinguished professional, humanistic and honorable reputation for contribution to a better world, as well as his invaluable contributions to the society. We're delighted to present the Fundación Mariscal Ibero-American Medal to Liliana Sánchez Cisnero, Humanistic Agents of Change.
Let's give every one of these recipients a nice sample.
My apologies. My apologies. I take that back.
Okay, thank you so much to everybody. I wasn't aware of this recognition, but how can I be happy if humankind is suffering? Actually, there's so many kinds of suffering in the world, but I have a great news. There's one way to find refuge in the world, and it's through service. If you help humankind, that emptiness you feel in your soul is going to fade away, it's going to disappear. So please, please don't believe me. Try and try and keep trying until you live your last breath. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now we can give everybody a nice round of applause. Everybody please rise and come to the front. Line up so they can take a beautiful picture for posterity. While this is going on, do we have Mayor of Puerto Vallarta, Francisco José Martínez Gil, in the audience? Se encuentra entre la audiencia el alcalde de Puerto Vallarta, el señor Francisco José Martínez Gil. Si está presente, por favor, háganos saber. Wave to the crowd, let's give him a nice hand too. Very nice. Great collections of informed that the mayor of Puerto Vallarta is here. So he's arriving in a couple of minutes, finding his way from the parking lot. So while he's making his way to the theater, let me just briefly explain what's going to happen during the breakout sessions. Okay? We're going to have three breakout sessions. I'm going to read to you in English and Spanish so everybody's aware of what comes after we do the number with Mr. Martinez here. So the breakout sessions bring together three groups: diplomacy, community, and commerce, to brainstorm innovative ideas aimed at advancing society with a particular focus on the Latino community. These sessions aim to generate feasible proposals to present to the Alaska government, fostering collaboration and driving impactful change. Together, we explore strategies to enhance diplomacy, strengthen community bonds, and promote economic prosperity, ensuring our voices are heard and our visions realized. Let's shape a brighter future through dialogue, creativity, and collective empowerment at the breakout sessions. Las sesiones de trabajo reúnen a tres grupos: diplomacia, comunidad y comercio, para generar ideas innovadoras destinadas a lograr avances en la sociedad. con un enfoque particular en la comunidad latina. Estas sesiones tienen como objetivo generar propuestas viables para presentar al gobierno de Alaska, fomentando la colaboración y promoviendo cambios sustanciales. Juntos analizamos estrategias para mejorar la diplomacia, fortalecer los lazos comunitarios y promover la prosperidad económica, asegurando que nuestras voces sean escuchadas y nuestras visiones se hagan realidad. Demos forma a un futuro más brillante a través del trabajo, la creatividad y el empoderamiento colectivo en las sesiones de trabajo. Igualmente, vamos a tener un grupo de personas bilingües, expertos bilingües, que están asistiendo con este trabajo. We're also going to have a collection of bilingual experts who will be assisting with this endeavor as well. The bilingual experts will support the community with topics related to investment, real estate advice, mortgage loan origination, life insurance, entrepreneurship, and more. También tenemos expertos bilingües que apoyarán a la comunidad con temas relacionados con la inversión, asesoría en bienes raíces, originación de préstamos hipotecarios, seguros de vida, emprendimiento y más. And while this is also happening, Katia and Marissa are going to be posing for pictures. You saw the mural by the entrance as well. También vamos a tener a Katia y la doctora Marissa enfrente del teatro, adentro donde está el mural, para que puedan tomar fotografías con ellos. Okay? Muchas gracias. Give me a thumbs up. Almost here. That's a good point. The whole time allotted for that is from 12:20 to 2 o'clock. Yes. Before we break to lunch. Correct. Absolutely. Para si tiene alguna pregunta acerca de qué tanto duran las sesiones de trabajo, inician de 12:20 y terminan hasta las 2 de la tarde, aproximadamente 1 hora y 40 minutos. Y a partir de las 2 tenemos un receso para comer, de 2 a 4. The reason why we have the mayor of Puerto Vallarta, Francisco José Martínez Gil, is because we are having an event right now where there's going to be an acceptance of a position from the foundation. And to do this, I would like to introduce Gabriela Castillo and the mayor of Puerto Vallarta, Francisco José Martínez Gil. Let's give him a nice round of applause. El alcalde de Puerto Vallarta, Francisco José Martínez Gil, y Gabriela Castillo, les invitará más a hacer esto.
Este acto protocolario va a ser realmente muy rápido por cuestiones de tiempo y debido al presidente municipal de Puerto Vallarta, México, que pase adelante, y a Maritza también, si me haces favor, Maritza, bien. Y Higuera, si gustan, presidente y Maritza solamente aquí al frente. Les pido por favor, nada más les voy a hacer su toma de protesta porque les quiero platicar que el presidente municipal de Puerto Vallarta, que está con nosotros como invitado especial, bueno, pues en Puerto Vallarta le hicimos la invitación para que él formara parte de la Fundación Honoris Causa y amablemente él dijo que sí, porque además le encantan nuestros proyectos, tenemos ya varios proyectos que vamos a empezar a trabajar con él y bueno, es un hombre que ha llevado el nombre de Puerto Vallarta muy en alto y que ha trabajado incansablemente para que este hermoso lugar de México brille a nivel internacional, tiene muchísimos programas. Y bueno, ahora con la Fundación Honoris Causa, pues va a ser algo muy interesante lo que vamos a hacer.
y les pido que extiendan su mano derecha y que sigan a lo que yo les voy a decir. Protesto. Seguir los lineamientos de la Fundación Honoris Causa Internacional, y así contribuir para el bienestar de la humanidad. Si así no lo hiciere, que el Comité Ejecutivo Internacional me lo demande. Muchas gracias. Bienvenidos a la Fundación. Muchas gracias. Bueno, pues ahora los invitamos al hall del teatro para los breakout sessions, las tomas de fotos y los expertos bilingües. Muchas gracias.
Thank you. So are you, Mark?